Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Shobha, consultant radiologist, Apollo Cradle Hospitals, Bangalore. Today I will be talking about the antenatal scans in twin pregnancy. Twin pregnancy is nowadays very common. It has become as common as 1 in 5 cases. The early pregnancy scans are done as soon as the pregnancy is confirmed to locate the pregnancy and also to number the pregnancies. Whenever we see the twin pregnancy, we have to see whether it is monochorionic twinning or dichorionic twinning. Monochorionic twins will have single placenta and the dichorionic twins have two placentae. Monochorionic twins may have single amniotic bag or diamniotic bags. Here we also look for the embryos with the heartbeat. Compared to dichorionic twinning, monochorionic twins have higher complications considered as higher risk pregnancies. As such, twin pregnancy is considered high risk pregnancy. Most of them will have twin to twin discordancy, and also they are very common with IUGR. In dichorionic diamniotic twin pregnancies, IUGR is expected up to 10 to 20% of pregnancies. In monochorionic twin pregnancies, the babies will be sharing a single placenta, so chances of one baby sharing more placenta or more blood supply and the other deprived of the blood supply can be there. There can be increased twin to twin discordancy seen in monochorionic twinning. So antenatal scans will help us to observe these things and also manage the pregnancy. As there is chances of increased PIH, gestational diabetes, and also PROM in dichorionic. As such, twin pregnancy is considered high risk pregnancy. There is increased prevalences of PIH, gestational diabetes, premature rupture of membranes, and premature delivery in twin pregnancy. Like for singleton pregnancies, twin pregnancies will also have scheduled antenatal scans. As there is high risk of twin to twin transfusion, or there is high risk of IUGR in twin pregnancies, the frequency of scans would also be more. The scans are spanned every month till 7 months in twin pregnancy to assess the growth of the baby, to assess the twin-to-twin transfusion, and to assess the growth discordancy. Later, after 7 months, every 3 weeks, the scans are advised to assess the blood supply and the growth of the baby. Similarly, in case of chromosomal anomalies or structural anomalies in the babies, selective chorionic villus sampling, selective amniocentesis, selective cardiocentesis can be advised to rule out any chromosomal anomalies. In case of proven abnormalities in the baby, prognosis is discussed and selective reduction of the baby can also be offered in twin pregnancy.